Hi, I'm iHanna, and this is my little notebook where I'm trying to paint almost daily. Now April, and I've just finished my March pages because I was slacking off because I have been a bit sick, and also my desk was full of stuff, so I couldn't really paint and film. So I've done the last couple of portraits because this month was all about portraits, and that's what we're going to take a look at now. If you haven't watched the previous videos, I have an intro on this little notebook that has 365 pages. I have a video of my January abstract pages, a compilation of all the time lapses from February, where I painted a lot of hearts, and now it's time for the March pages. I hope you enjoy. And if you want to see what I'm doing in April, you can follow me on Instagram, where I will be posting a few of these. Let's jump in. Here we go with the first portrait of the month. I don't really remember why I decided to go for portraits. I asked on Instagram for advice on what to do, and somebody suggested portraits, and I guess I was really curious if I could do it. I'm not really a great painter, but I love playing with colors, and my portraits are, like I said in the introduction to this video, my portraits are very experimental, so I'm just playing with lines and colors. Here I'm using my Carandash Neo colors that are water soluble, and then acrylic on top of that, and then some charcoal marks, and then some more scribbles and paint. I just keep on adding paint and color until I think it's good enough or I really like it. So I really liked the first two really messy portraits, and then I went on to this is day three in March, and I did a little bit more orderly painting with watercolors, and I think it looks like an illustration that could be in a children's book or a magazine, and I'm really happy with it. Then I go on and do some experiments with the colors, and just wanting to play. And sometimes I think I succeed to make something that I'm really liking, and sometimes not so much. Then I just turn the page and start in my next painting another day, and do something that is a little bit cuter, maybe a little bit more me. And I have really enjoyed trying to do something different each day. So here's a girl with green hair, and then I go on to make a girl with yellow hair. So it's just like I'm trying to push the limits of what a portrait can be, even though of course they are not cubism or something like that. It's really straightforward, rather girlish most of the time. I tried to experiment with doing ugly colors or colors that are not really meant for portraits, but then I feel like I'm failing, so I go back to my favorite colors. I mean, I think, I don't know if it's because I think that red and pink are my favorite colors that those portraits become better. By the way, this girl power portrait was made on March 8th in National Women's Day, and on the 9th of March, Barbie has her 60th birthday, so I did a portrait of Barbie. Then I lit a candle, had some tea, and on the 9th of March I did this little cutesy girl again, once again, going back to my favorite colors, although I'm mixing in a bit of purple and blue in the background. Portraits can be done in many different ways, and I don't think there are any specific rules. I mean, if you want to draw lifelike, you have to practice. But if you want to do just something fun with color, I think you can play around and see what you find that you like. If you like lots of red and colorful hair, I think you should try to do a portrait like that. And this is a bit of a self-portrait. It started like a self-portrait, but then she looks a bit angry, so I don't think it's me. And the shoulder is totally off. I just, yeah. She looks like she's slumping. But that's okay. It's just another page. And we move on to another portrait. Love doing the long noses. And I don't really have a great skin tone color, so I'm using my orange and the beige, and I don't know, sometimes it really works, sometimes it doesn't. And I often start out letting my girls be bold, and sometimes they stay like that. Here I'm also adding in some flowers and longing for spring. We've seen some spring flowers for sure, but it's not really the kind of weather where you want to sit outside just yet here in Sweden. And I think this one turned out really cute, with a little bit of a purple shadow. Almost halfway through the month, I was brave. And I did a little guy portrait. I think he's a Frenchman with a purple barrette. And this one is a little bit inspired by Tammy, who does these girls with swirly hairs. And I love the swirly hair. So I made her blue and purple hair. And some makeup. And she's saying hi. So this is the second guy. I painted him with liquid watercolors because it's been something I wanted to try, and I had a bottle of red, but I couldn't just leave it red, so I added in some of my black watercolors to him too. And that seeped through totally to the next page, so no other choice than to cover it up in white acrylics and do a little acrylic portrait on the next page. I think this little girl with her blue hair, kind of crouching in the dark, turned out really great too. And without any intention of drawing a kid, that happened. This happened, so I gave her a 1970 sweater in with green flowers, quite like the one I had when I was a kid. And to balance that, here's an old crazy lady who's really worried about the baby, and she can't really handle herself with all those curls and the purple in her face. Here's another purple haired girl. with a lot of water, so the colors are running into each other, but that's also intentional and a play with where you can go and how much paint you can splatter without really destroying the feel of it being a portrait. This one is called Sandibel, and she was an anime, the only anime figure I saw as a kid. She was wearing this white apron and had yellow hair. And here's a quick brown drawing of a little reindeer girl. I don't know, I just felt like trying to do antlers, and I think she turned out cute, so I need to go back to that idea. So I've done a lot of young women, and then I wanted to do another old lady. So this one got purple hair, and I'm using my colored pencils to color in. It takes a little bit longer, but it was really fun to bring those out. And here I wanted to do the kind of drawing we did as kids. I don't know if you did girls like this. Big puffy lips, princess crown, yellow hair, and I totally couldn't figure out how we did the noses, so that's just an epic fail. Never mind, let's move on. Let's do a portrait that fills up the entire page. This was drawn on a Friday, and it's supposed to be Greta, who is striking for the future from school. And the text says, planning to have a future. So not very looking like her, but anyway. And this crazy lady is like more of a Disney figure. And yeah, this is the last one. Yeah, 31 drawings. This is what the book looks like now after painting in it for 3 months. And I'm not sure what I will do in April, so stay tuned, and you are most welcome to ask me any questions in the comments. And until the next video, I hope you have a great creative day, week, month, and see you next time.